In part 4 of my UI UX Design Crash Course series, we'll cover layout. Layout defines how different elements of your designs are put together on the screen. No matter what are you designing, a careful arrangement of content is essential for showing the users what they need to know and what they can do with it. There are several elements that go into and define a good layout, and you need to follow them in order to be a successful designer. Those elements are visual hierarchy, flow, balance, gestalt principles, and dynamics. You will meet with the concept of visual hierarchy in all forms of graphic design. In short, the most important elements should be the most prominent, and less important ones the most withdrawn. Good visual hierarchy allows users to immediately identify the importance of different content pieces, the relationship between each other and available actions. You can define that importance through size, shape, arrangement, density, and color. The most prominent example of size principle in action is present in the way we format text. We can use titles and subtitles to signify order and importance to the user. The logic here is simple. The bigger something is, the more important it is. Then, through color and shape, we can not only group similar items together, but also we can highlight and distinguish any item that is more important from that group. We can also use positioning of the items to indicate importance and relation to other ones. Put similar items close to each other and immediately our brains are telling us that it's a group of items with similar functions. Put an item away from everything and it looks important, focusing our attention on it. Next element that defines any good layout is flow. We created by structuring our content into grids and lists. By arranging elements such as headers and summaries, as well as separating content with empty space, we create a distinct visual rhythm that irresistibly attracts attention. In digital design, readability is crucial as it guides the user through information and encourages them to take an action. Creating a grid-based design will allow you to focus on content, provided that your layout is visually consistent and balanced. You can check it out for yourself how the layout prepared without grid alignment compares to the one with it. Grids are present in all digital projects and are a foundation of responsive designs and those capable of accommodating dynamic content. I already covered this topic in my video dedicated to responsive design. You will find the link to it in this video description. Gestalt is a term that originates from psychology. It's a German word for a figure or shape, and it refers to the way people perceive visual objects. In layout design, Gestalt principles allow us to create interfaces that follow that natural perception and provide the best user experience. I already mentioned two of those aspects in this video, similarity and distance. Apart from those two, we also have complementation and continuity or visual flow. Our minds tend to close and create shapes, even if they aren't drawn directly. That's why proper alignment of design elements is so crucial for our interfaces. By aligning the elements, we are creating lines through their edges that users will naturally follow. Extension of this rule is a visual flow, which refers to the pathway that users follow. It's also directly connected to the visual hierarchy. In a properly designed layout, users will follow key points of focus that will lead them through the design. But how to design good visual flow? The simplest way to do it is to apply curved or straight suggested lines for connection of interface elements. It will create a visual narration that users can follow. One of the prime examples of it are layouts dedicated to forms, where fields create lines that lead to call to action buttons. Final aspect of layout design I want to mention is dynamics. All of the mentioned principles are coming directly from graphic design and are applicable to static media like newspapers, billboards, or posters. But in digital design, we have an additional dimension, time. Or maybe more clearly, interactions. That means the user can scroll, zoom, tap, or click, and the interface will react. So our layouts can be interacted with in a way impossible for classic media. And you have a couple of options to choose from, like tabs, accordions, expanded or moving panels that give users some control over the layout. In the next part of this course, we'll cover design for different devices.